That's 1 to 25. So that's a scaled down version of this gallery. There's something good about having this a physical model that you can sort of walk around. You can get a sense of how it's going to translate in a more physical sense. So I did like that aspect of the model. I first was introduced to the Art Foundation in 2008 when I moved to Alice Springs, and I was invited to be the coordinator of the Alice Prize during that year. And so I was actually employed by the Art Foundation to coordinate the Alice Prize and install the Alice Prize. That led to me being employed at the Araluen Arts Centre, so I could maintain an ongoing connection with the Art Foundation and with the collection. And so my first role at Araluen was as a collections officer. And so I worked very closely with that collection, sort of maintaining the collection, getting it ready for exhibitions and installing it in exhibitions. Often art prizes are done, they're usually through a gallery will sort of do it. I don't know of any other voluntary run art prizes. I think it's unique. And I think Alice Springs has two arts organisations who have done that. And the Art Foundation, they started the Alice Prize in 1970 and have continued to run that. But the Arts Society also, they formed their own art prize, the Caltex Art Award from 1968. And so that once again, that was run by a small community arts organisation and ran for a few decades before it stopped. So it's Alice Springs is pretty special in terms of how it can achieve that and through the commitment of people on those committees. But I guess the interesting thing is that when the Art Foundation formed the Alice Prize, Araluen didn't exist, and it was so Araluen didn't open until 1984, and that's and it was through the lobbying of those two arts organisations that Araluen was actually built. And the reason that they were lobbying so hard for Araluen is because both of those arts organisations had amassed their own collections of works. So the Art Foundation had amassed that collection of works from the Alice Prize, and they were struggling to actually store those works. Where do we house these works, and how do we display these works? And so they decided that we need an art gallery in Alice Springs that can where these works can be housed and where these works can be exhibited. So it was through the lobbying of those organisations that enabled Araluen to be built. And so it was that, and so those two, the collections that those two art organisations amassed, they became the basis of the Araluen art collection. So that was the beginnings of the Araluen art collection. And so the beginnings began many years before there was a building here. So it's quite an interesting story and quite unique in terms of art prizes in this country.